Can you see the presentation?
Yes.
Yes, we can see it.
Perfect. So one second. Okay, yes. Welcome to our presentation of Mariette and me, Isabel. And within our project, we studied the relationship between probiotics and the symptoms of autism spectrum disorder. And in this project, we propose a treatment effect of a specific probiotic to alleviate autism syndrome disorder symptoms. So I will quickly explain to you what ASD is. ASD is a neurodevelopmental disorder and is characterized by the person's diminishing ability to communicate and interact with other people. And core symptoms of ASD are restricted repetitive patterns of behaviors, interests, and activities. And in addition to these core symptoms, abnormalities in sensory processing lead to an avoidance reaction to calm oneself down, for example, when feeling too many emotions. And gastrointestinal symptoms are also characteristics of ASD. A study that compared the microbiome of persons with ASD to a healthy control group reported that ASD patients have a different and a less diverse gut microbiome with decreased levels of several bacteria. And the large body of preclinical literature states that the gut has a bidirectional influence on the brain, and this is also called the brain-gut axis. And the gut system consists of a microbiome, and the gut microbiome consists of different bacteria. And the balance of these bacteria has many effects on both the well-being and also disease of a person. And therefore, the gut microbiome plays an important role since it influences it and has an effect on the functions of the central nervous system, the neuroendocrine and neuroimmune system. And it is even argued that the brain-gut communication may cause several diseases, for example, autoimmune and central nervous system disorders. In the brain-gut axis, bacteria initiate signals that are transmitted from the gut to the central nervous system, which can be transmitted via the blood circulation of the vagus nervus to the brain. And in the picture, you can see the bidirectional relationship between the brain-gut axis and intestinal inflammation. And for this example, it is associated with inflammatory bowel disease and the severity of anxiety states and depressive status. And the brain-gut axis also involves different signaling pathways, such as the neurological, metabolic, hormonal, and immunological pathways. And scientists found out the difference in the microbiome of ASD people compared to healthy people and started to research the effects of the microbiome on ASD symptoms. And the studies suggest that alterations in the microbiome promote symptoms of ASD through the microbial metabolites, immune regulation, and direct interact with the brain. So they state that probiotic treatments targeting the gut microbiome have beneficial effects to improve ASD symptoms. So overall, one of the options to alter the microbiome are probiotics. And probiotics are described by the WHO as living microorganisms, which can be beneficial for health if administered in adequate amounts. And one of the probiotics that has an effect on ASD symptoms is the Lactobacillus reuteri. And therefore, we will focus on this probiotic. And researchers have reversed social deficits that are associated with ASD in mice already by a bacterial-based therapy. And they were able to correct social behavior, for example, the sensory process through the intake of L-reuteri. And in 2018, researchers from the Bayer College of Medicine have reversed social deficits that are associated with ASD in mice by a bacterial-based therapy. And they found out that no matter the origin of the disorder, they were able to correct social behavior through the Lactobacillus reuteri. And therefore, this report will focus on how and together with what other factors the Lactobacillus reuteri can correct social behavior in people with ASD. And in an interview, one of the researchers stated this quote, which you can see on the slide, and I will quickly read out one sentence to you. In this research, we determined that the vagus nerve and the oxytocin dopamine reward system were both necessary for the social behaviors to be restored. And because of the word restored, we built a learning process model about which Mariette will tell you no more.
Yes, thank you. So here you see our model that we created for MATLAB. And as mentioned before, we choose to make a learning model. And this means that our model has different layers, the adaptation levels. And first of all, the base level consists of the temporal causal network model, which can be further found in the book indicated on this slide of Jan Ter in chapter 9. So this part of the model is shown by the pink knots. You can see, and so we propose some adaptations in this model to show the effect of our theory on the symptoms of autism. So first of all, in the base model, we added the control state X16. That's also a big knot, yeah. And this state, this X16, is able to influence the X3, which is the feeling state of the already existing model. So this can influence the feeling state, so the feeling state will not become too high and will not go into the avoidance loop. As you can see now, the X6 and X12 are the avoidance loop. So if X3 becomes too high, it goes into the avoidance loop, because people who have autism often find it very difficult to control their own feelings, so it becomes too high and they cannot suppress their feelings, so they avoid the situation. That's what happened with the X6 and X12 when they go into that loop. So with X16, we can try to suppress this feeling state, and X16 is influenced by X17, it's on the first layer. This value influences the connection weight between X16 and X3. So this connection can become stronger if X17 increases. So this person is then is being able to control their own feelings, so they can decrease their feeling, but does not become too high. So what we also added in the base level are the red knots, those four. And this is for food intake, the LRT intake, and then two gut system states. So we assume that this does not directly influence the pink knots, but by the adaptation levels, so there's a learning effect. In the first layer, we also added X24. And this is the carrying capacity value. So the value of X24 is affected by X21. And this stands for how healthy someone's gut system is. So, and that is influenced by the fiber intake, because we assume that when the person eats a lot of fibers, their gut system is very healthy. And with a healthy gut system, the person's gut is being able to accept bacteria like LRT to grow, and then it only has an effect. So back to X24, when this value is increased, this parameter goes to the X20, and X20 is the level of LRT in the gut system. So when X24 is a higher number, then it influences the ability for LRT to grow. So there's a higher possibility for LRT to grow, so that level can increase, and there's no limit for that bacteria to grow. So that's positive effect of X24 on X20. So when X20 increases, the parameters of X17, X18, and X19, the numbers are increasing as well. So that's the learning effect that then happens. And in the second layer, the H speed, X18, and the M persistence state, X19, affect the W state on the middle layer. And these are both affected by the value of Elbert theory, which was X20 in the base level. This means that they start to increase if the LRT increases, and when the value of LRT increases, the M state igniting the persistence state also increases, and this means that it's not a permanent effect. So it's not after you take a bacteria and it goes away that the effect will remain, but it's a temporary effect. So we will show the first simulation now. The next slide, please. Yes. So in this picture, we can see that there's not enough urine effect to avoid the avoidance loop for someone with autism. You can see that because of the loops are just going up and down, going up and down. And this means that when feelings are going up, this person is going into the avoidance loop, and then feelings are, of course, directly going down again because they just avoid the situation. So it's no stabilized effect. And what we did here for the simulation was the initial value for food intake was very low. We gave it a 0.3 value. And because 0.3 is very low, this is an unhealthy food intake. What I explained before is if someone has an unhealthy food intake, which means not that many fibers, the gut system is not able to really accept the bacteria that you take. So even though you take a lot of Elderberry bacteria that can give an effect, this bacteria is not being able to be accepted in your gut system and can not grow. So the effect on social behavior for someone with autism and the avoidance loop is not being that the person is still going into this avoidance loop. So there's no learning effect because the good system is not healthy enough. Let me show the next simulation, please. Yes, thank you. So in this simulation, we only show a few lines because otherwise it was too much chaotic to see. But here we can see that there is a learning effect in the end. So first we see again those loops, which means that there is still an avoidance loop in the beginning because this person, the Elderberry bacteria needs to grow in this gut system. So the effect is not happening yet in the beginning, but in the end, after some time, the learning effect is shown, and then you see that all the states are stabilizing, so also the feeling. So let me see. So the Elderberry effect depends on the carrying capacity value, so which means which is affected by how healthy your gut system is. And in this simulation, the carrying capacity is influenced by the food intake value of 0.9. And last, the first one we said 0.3, which was too low. And now with 0.9, the good system is healthy enough to let the Elderberry bacteria grow. And this ultimately is this learning effect that we wanted. So this person is not going into the avoidance loop anymore, but is able to suppress their own feelings. So that means that the X3 state, which was the feeling state, stabilizes and it's not going into those loops anymore. And we also see in the simulation that the light blue line that starts at 0.01 and it goes all the way towards the value of 0.9. And this is the value of LOTV within the gut system. So you can see that it's indeed being able to grow.
Sorry for interruption, you have 1 minute left.
Okay, thank you. I think we're almost done. Okay, then we go to, so the level is 0.9, which was a good level, and then we reported it's not there anymore. Then we can go to the final slide, because this was the verification of our model. So in this table, you can see the outcome of the analysis to evaluate whether our model generated correct values. But the difference between the XI at a certain time point with the impact XI is less than 0.01, we can say that we have generated the correct values. And below in the green, we can see that all the values are below 0.01. And we can say that our model generated correct values with the accuracy of the maximal deviation of the minus 3 point, the one over there. Yeah, that's it.
Great, thank you. Are there any questions?
Final statement, I forgot.
One short question, please.
Yeah.
Alexey, may I ask one question?
Only briefly, because we are 5 minutes behind the schedule.
Okay, very briefly. What is the principal difference between probiotics and drugs?
Sorry, what the difference is between drugs and probiotics?
Between the probiotics and drugs.
Well, you mean drugs like medicine?
Sorry?
Yeah, yeah. I guess that was the question.
Okay, well, probiotic is just like bacteria that you take as a supplement and has a beneficial effect on the host. You can maybe sometimes say it's a drug because it has a health effect, but I think in general, it's just not called a drug, but it's probiotic. I hope that answers your question.
Okay, thank you. Maybe we can ask other questions during a panel discussion.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Let's move forward to the next topic.